Hi, this is Asa, and welcome to my audio experience. Remember, if the body can get sick, it can also get well. So our lifestyle is what matters more than just about anything else. Our lifestyle determines the kind of health we're going to have. And so the foods we eat, air we breathe, the water we drink, the exercise we get, the stress we manage, all of that matters. And so creating a plan that you can balance is really the ultimate key. And that's what will give you the key to an amazing life as well, as to be able to do that. So I encourage you to walk in that path, because you can do really, really well if you're making the right kind of choices. Let's go to the phones and talk to Ned. Hi, Ned.
I have sores on my head that won't go away. And I have knots like at the bottom of my skull that just came up like today, and I have them in my groin area, like knots. And I was just wondering, I've had this sore for about 6, 7, 8 months.
I would go in and just have your dermatologist look at it, because those sores could be several types. And when you start talking about skin, someone really needs to look at it and take a peek. Because looking at the actual sore, analyzing it, seeing the location, really that's what you have to do with skin conditions. I mean, there's a lot of could-bes that we could actually get into, but it's really a waste of time. I would go and definitely talk to them and just get in with your family doctor, or is a family doctor will probably give you a good overview, but if it looks pretty detailed, they may send you over to a dermatologist for a specialist, and at least you can get a good thought and good move there with what to do, because it probably can be remedied pretty easily. They've kind of got an idea, but I just would have them look at it first and foremost. Good thing to know is this, though. I do want to tell you this, is that skin conditions come from the inside out, not the outside in. So there is something internally going on, probably in the digestive tract, that is what's leading to a lot of this. So you want to have that looked at first. That is a big key. All right. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Lines are open. Give us a call or go to the website. Being a father is a great joy in life. They've done a study, though, which I think is really interesting. And this is, I'm going to talk to you about this and just see what you think. So a new study looked at Finnish men, okay, who became fathers of at least one child before the age 25. And they said that men who are fathers before the age of 25 are more likely to die in their middle age. Younger men were less likely to have planned for children and need to become breadwinners quickly to support their new families. Study lead author Alina Inio, who's a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Helsinki in Finland, said suddenly taking on the combined role of father and breadwinner may have caused considerable psychological and economic stress for young men not ready in his new role. Researchers wanted to understand better why these studies have shown similar patterns, and using the census data, they drew a sample of 10% of Finnish men born between 1950 or 40 and 50. So this is how far back they went. What's interesting is overall 5% of the fathers, or 1 in 20, died in their late 40s or early 50s. The most common cause of death was heart attack, alcohol-related illnesses. See, they were going to the alcohol, handling the stress, managing the stress. And the death rate sounds high, but they said life expectancy is pretty average for high-income countries. And for the fact that men were born during after World War II, especially in a traumatic era in Finland, the war effects had largely waned by that time, so that wasn't a major impact on them. But the findings, they said, for these men, it says, whatever the case, it's important for young men to wait until they're sure they're ready for the responsibilities of fatherhood. Some young men can be pretty mature at an early age and others not at all. So it depends on the maturity level. But yeah, it will raise your stress level, no doubt about it. And be sure that you're ready financially to take care of bringing a child in. So that is definitely a huge piece. And it's one of the greatest joys, probably, if not the. And so being ready for that, it's going to bring stress no matter what. I mean, it just is what it is. It's life, but it's a wonderful stress, and knowing how to handle that and walking with that, it just takes it's a learning curve for anyone. No one gives you a manual on how to do it. 888-283-7272. Give us a call or go to the website. So if you haven't found our lifestyle provider, someone in your area that believes the same way we do, all this nutrition and lifestyle-based care we talk about, go to the website. We've got team members that are always standing by to help you. Our lifestyle providers always there to help you, and you can find great information there, people to help you go to that next level. I'm pretty excited about this. Cancer rates continue to decline in the U.S. So we rant and rave all the time about how cancer is one of the leading causes of death, and it is. It's almost trumped heart disease. It's close, not there yet, but it's close. And they say cancer death rates continue to decline in the U.S. because of a lot of the anti-smoking efforts, which has cut down the lung cancer deaths. By the way, if you ever look this up and you wanted to know the death rates and which is the greater and that sort of thing, the lung cancer rates, do you know that that's the number one killer? 33% lung cancer. Everything else is like prostate, 6%. Colon cancer, 8%, right? So we hear all these other cancers that are devastating. Pancreatic cancer, 3% or 2%, something like that. But lung cancer, 33%. It is the number one that can take you out from a cancer perspective. So the four major cancers are lung, colorectal, breast, and prostate. And two-thirds of them are on the decline. So I'm pretty excited about that. It's exciting. So you think about... the alternative world, traditional world, there's all kinds of debates. Everybody gets frustrated. They think money's not being used right. But I know quite a few people in cancer research that I've just met and colleagues that did great work. I mean, amazing work. American Cancer Society, National Cancer Institute, U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. All these folks have, of course, monitor and manage a lot of this, and they manage the funds and the studies that go on. But there's been some great research done and accomplished. So as much as the alternative guys, which I like the complementary medicine. I'm into natural-based things very much so, as you hear the show. But I also get excited when money's being put to use and people are seeing some good things happen. So very exciting to see that it is on the decline. The big challenge is what I'm not fired up about, and I get kind of fired up about, really fired up about, is the fact that obesity is on the increase. I mean, it's crazy. It's almost at 70% now of Americans are overweight. Really? 70% of Americans are overweight. That is crazy. We have to do something about it. I am definitely on a mission. You can't get around me very long and not deal with that, because I will definitely bring it up. It's a big deal because it's taking us out. It's giving us the main metabolic conditions of heart disease, and it's giving us issues with high cholesterol, blood sugar issues, high triglycerides. It's causing all that. So we drop the weight, we can come out of some of all these different metabolic conditions. We'll be right back. More on-call radio. Check us out on the web and give us a call, 888-283-7272.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
To find out more, connect with On-Call Radio online at InShapeNetwork.com.
Whatever you're struggling with, remember, if the body can get sick, it can also get well. It's about lifestyle. So the choices we make every single day can and will determine the kind of health we're going to have. It's critical. It's vital that we make the right choices. And our health is our greatest wealth in every aspect of it. So we have to make the right choices each and every day. Let's go to the phones and talk to Janet. Hi, Janet.
I've been taking vitamin D3 for low vitamin D, and I've been taking it for a while, and now my calcium is high, and I'm afraid it's damaging my blood vessels, and I want to know how to get that calcium down quickly so I won't harm myself, because I know having prolonged high calcium, it damages your blood vessels.
Right. But the offset to that for the high calcium is vitamin K2. And you get plenty of K2 in your greens, no doubt. Like if you eat salads with spinach or kale or turnip greens, anything like that. If you do that, you're going to get a lot of vitamin K2, which makes the calcium more utilized, and it keeps the vessels more pliable. So that's pretty important. But another area you need to look at too that I think is pretty important is making sure your vitamin D is the right quality. So whole food-based vitamin D is important. And again, I'm not big on excess calcium supplementation or anything like that, because if you're getting 2 or 3 green salads a day and you're eating nuts and seeds, and if you're eating some dairy, which dairy's not even not that big of a deal, I'm bigger on the green vegetables for the calcium levels, then you're going to be, you should be getting just enough. Your body can take what you eat, and it has its own buffering mechanism. So the buffering mechanism works really well, and it supports the body. So you don't have to be overly concerned. What I would be concerned about is making sure you have enough K2. That's what goes in and balances everything out, and that's what's a big key. All right. More information, too, is at our website. I've written articles on that, and you could probably go a little bit deeper if you wanted to spend a little more time with it. 888-283-7272. Give us a call. If you haven't checked out our lifestyle providers, check it out. You'll find all kinds of healthcare providers in your area that believe the same way we do. All this nutrition and lifestyle-based care that we talk about is there to help you. So regardless if you struggle and you want to know what to do, and they can help you. Of course, our team members are there each and every day to take you to the next level with your health and with your life. It's a key. Skipping breakfast. Is that you? Oh, I've got it. I have to hit on this. So many people that we talk to, emails, they're like, I don't want to eat breakfast. I just want to drink my coffee and eat a donut. And I'm like, really? We're still doing that now? We're still doing that. We're still skipping breakfast. And when grandma told us how important breakfast is, the most important what? Meal of the day. It is. It really is. Break the fast. You've been sleeping 6, 7, 8 hours. Your body needs food. Time to break the fast. It works wonders for your metabolism and getting your overall metabolic rate where it needs to be. It's an absolute key. So skipping breakfast, you don't want to do that if you have type 2 diabetes. You're running out the door eating something that's at a high sugar level like that bagel or bowl of cereal. Don't do it. You always want to have equal amounts of lean protein sources like chicken, fish, beef, or eggs, low glycemic carbohydrates in the form of fruits and vegetables, and then your good healthy fats, your almonds, your walnuts, your avocados. Having the right kind of foods in the right way, in the right manner, will make a huge difference for you. And that's what I would focus on. I would focus on getting the right kind of foods in on a regular basis. And there's been studies done on this. And of course, there's a high relevance of skipping breakfast right now in the U.S. High blood sugar levels after meals are strongly associated with a rapid decline in what's called beta cell function. So the beta cells are cells in the pancreas that produce insulin, which is a hormone that's necessary for the body to use carbohydrates in food as fuel. So high blood sugar peaks, and also with earlier development of heart disease. So you can really start packing on not only the pounds, but you can really start affecting the body toward diabetes in a negative way. That's what you don't want to do. So keep everything simple. I mean, keep some of the healthy fats in your meals. You want to do lean quality proteins definitely at breakfast. Need the protein. And go easy on the carbs. You don't need three biscuits and 2 donuts and a big glass of orange juice. You don't need all that. That's old school. It's old thinking. What you need is more of like 2 eggs, a bowl of fresh berries, maybe some green tea, and say a tablespoon of fish oil or maybe a handful of walnuts or almonds. Now that is a great breakfast. You can even add more eggs than that. But I would keep everything balanced. Your body functions best when it's given balance. It's what it wants, what it likes. And that's what you should always shoot for if you want optimal health. You're listening to On Call Radio. Check us out on the web. If you're struggling with your health, no matter what it is, remember, if the body can get sick, it can also get well. So don't lose hope. One thing I don't want you to lose is hope. Don't lose it, because it's powerful. It can help thrust you and take you to that next level if you're willing to let it. It's an absolute key. One other key I want to tell you that's really important is that when you're talking about suicide prevention for women, social life is a key. And we do see a lot of that. You know, now we're seeing a lot of suicide. You get a lot of that in the news. We're seeing more of it. It's more frequent than it used to be. They're saying social media can tie into that a little bit. Don't know if that's true or not. But one thing you want to look at for sure is keeping your relationships. I think it's one of the keys of our lives in a healthy life is to have good friendships, good family relationships, people that are close to you that you love and care about, that care about you and that you can spend time and quality time with. So if you're going through a tough time, there is someone to talk to. If you're going through challenges, there's someone that can help walk you through. Now, as I believe, Christ will always walk you through no matter what you're going through. It's great to have people that you can lock arms with here to carry you through those tough times and be a support to someone else. It's not all about you. It's about them as well. 888-283-7272. You're listening to On Call Radio. Check us out on the web.
Did you know that you can listen to the Asa Rx audio experience on Spotify and Pandora? For all the ways to watch and listen, check out our show page at asarx.com/experience.
To find out more, visit the show online, inshapenetwork.com.
Struggling with, remember, if the body can get sick, it can also get well. It is about lifestyle. So the choices we make every single day can and will determine the kind of health we're going to have. It's true. So the great news is that we can make some great strides in our health. You really can make a difference. You just have to understand what you're doing. So the exercise we get, the foods we eat, air we breathe, water we drink, stress we manage, all determines the kind of health we're going to have. Plums, we're going to talk about a little bit. So I always pick a food most of the time. And I just pick foods that randomly will help our bodies. And I get excited because food can be our best medicine. I think that when we eat the wrong kind of foods over a long period of time, it can cause our bodies to break down and not do that well. But if we eat the right kind of foods on a regular basis, then we can really begin to thrive. And we can go to that next level in our health. And that's what it's about. So plums I'm going to talk about. Remember, food either brings health to the body or it takes health out of the body. So the body doesn't know the difference between baked chicken and fried chicken or French fries and broccoli. But we do. And so we want to make good, healthy choices each day so that our bodies get everything that it needs. It's a key. It's an absolute key. And we want to focus on that and give the body what it needs. All right, so we're going to talk about plums. Strong, and I like the taste of them personally, but the antioxidant protection they have is pretty strong. So even the dried version, which are prunes, we all know about those, great for the digestion and great for being constipated, all that jazz, but they have a lot of what's called chlorogenic acid. And these substances are found in plums, phytonutrients, as we call them, are classified as phenols, and their function as antioxidants have been documented for ages. We've known about them. So they help our cell membranes, our brain cells, and pretty much every cell in the body to protect them from a lot of the free radical damage. And there's better iron absorption plus antioxidant protection from the vitamin C. So the plums or prunes can make iron more readily available because of the high vitamin C content in the fruit, which ranks it as one of the highest sources of vitamin C, believe it or not, coming from themselves from the prunes. Now, they also can help support healthy blood sugar levels and weight loss. So prunes, a lot of the soluble fiber helps to normalize blood sugar by slowing down the rate at which food leaves the stomach by delaying absorption of glucose. And the soluble fiber also increases insulin sensitivity and can therefore play a helpful role in prevention and treatment of the type 2 diabetes. So prunes fiber for regularity can lower also cholesterol and intestinal protection. So prunes are well known for the ability to prevent constipation. And we've known that for a long time. But of course, it's the transit time of the fecal matter through the colon that is so vital and so important. So things speed up when you have fermented prunes. They have this insoluble fiber in them, and there's a fatty acid that's produced called butyric acid. And it serves as a primary fuel for the cells of the large intestine. And the propionic acid produced from the prunes, insoluble fiber, may also be partly responsible too. The HMG-CoA reductase, which is an enzyme involved in the production of cholesterol by the liver, that's another one as well. So lastly, the insoluble fiber that's provided by prunes can feed friendly bacteria. So there's what we call prebiotics, and then that helps to feed probiotics. So probiotics are the good bacteria that we put back in our digestive tract, right? And so that's what we do. The prebiotics help make an impact with that. So it's a great food overall. If you've never added plums into your normal routine, I highly suggest it. Very beneficial, great for the digestive support. Amazing. Now, I've got more articles on this at our website. If you haven't checked out our lifestyle providers, healthcare providers in your area that believe the same way we do, all the information is there and you can get the help that you need. Pretty amazing. So if you need to learn how to lose weight, feel better, you don't know kind of which way to go with exercise and how to come up with a good game plan, or you're taking a bunch of medications and are just kind of freaking out and don't know what to do, they can help. Lifestyle providers are powerful at taking you by the hand and laying out a plan for you, so all this stuff makes sense. Skipping breakfast, we always know, is a bad idea, but what about, we talk about that, but what about your other meals throughout the day? What about eating before bed? Now, this is a big one that we get hit on quite a bit here on the show. Eating before bed's another one that I just want to tackle. If you eat before bed, true or false, it will make you gain weight, and it's horrible to eat before bed. Okay, the answer is false, because actually eating before bed can be beneficial to your health, believe it or not. If you eat a meal, I like to do proteins and a little bit of fat. If you eat proteins while you sleep, it helps to maintain lean muscle tissue. Fats will help slow release of the breakdown throughout the night. Plus, they support blood sugar levels. So the better your blood sugar levels are stabilized while you sleep, the better you're going to sleep. That's definitely for sure. So also, if you're looking to lose weight, I always have people eat before bed. And you won't, if you do proteins and fats, you won't disrupt your body's natural hormone rhythms while you're sleeping. It's the carbohydrates that can shut that down. So you just want to make sure you're not getting a lot of sugar, or any sugar for that matter, right before you go to bed. That's really what shuts everything down. Keep your proteins and your fats where they need to be, and that will keep you in a good place. 888-283-7272. Let's go to Steven. Hi, Steven.
I was in the hospital 2 days for tests for numbness on the tip of the tongue and around the lips and vision issues associated with it. Did a full scan and CAT scan and all of the tests the neurologist had, and we found nothing. Of course, we're concerned about a stroke.
And that should be something of concern, that's for sure. One thing I would look at is get evaluated, have even a second or third opinion, and even have maybe an integrative based physician that can take a look at you. Looking at other areas, I mean, since the standard medical testing has been done, they can take a look at you from different areas and really see if your body's breaking down or not in certain ways. I mean, stroke can definitely be an option, but it could be something else on the neurological side that has nothing to do with stroke. Could be very possible. And especially with the tip of your tongue like that, I would have just another opinion. I'll tell you, an osteopathic physician, which is a DO that does integrative type work, or a chiropractic physician is another great option that looks more along the lines nutritionally at the body and how it functions. Those may be some good options, at least for you to get another opinion. It's always good to have multiple opinions so you can make a great educated decision for you. I mean, because at the end of the day, it's your body. And so you want to make the best decision that you can for you. It's always the case. Let's go to Ernie. Hi, Ernie. Welcome.
I wanted to ask about citric acid allergies, and also want to know thoughts on the rumor about aluminum deodorant causing cancer because people can't sweat.
Well, let's address both of those. I mean, the citric acid itself, a lot of times, just the body's inability to break things down. So whoever, when you're talking about citric acid allergies, you got to step back and look at what's causing the allergic response in the body. And a lot of time it's that histamine. The histamine is produced by the mast cells in the body. So it could just be you're not handling certain foods very well, whether it's an orange or whatever, because citric acid is found in quite a few foods. So I would just first make sure that you're digesting properly. You may need to use enzymes or what's called proteolytic enzymes that can be very helpful for that. You can get that from pineapple, by the way. Proteolytic enzymes, that's where they get a lot of the supplement form. Papaya and bromelain both have, or papaya and pineapple both have bromelain, which is a real strong proteolytic enzyme, helps to break down the proteins. Pretty exciting. So that can help tremendously when you've got allergies, cutting out dairy products. And also, like milk, cheese, and yogurt, I know, probably love it, but it's okay. If you cut it out for a period of time, about 8 weeks, you can notice a difference. You don't have to get rid of it forever. Just sometimes it's good to eliminate it for a period of time. And then your wheat products, your breads, your pastas, your cereals, your crackers, all of that makes a big difference. And you want to look at eliminating that as well. So those are big keys. Now, the other piece, too, that we're talking about, in the aluminum and the deodorants, there's a strong link. Okay. It's not just, it is technically a theory because it's not a formal study done on it, but aluminum, not so much causing the cancers, but they're concerned about some of the brain chemistry issues with that, meaning that things like Alzheimer's and dementia, there's some links with metals along those lines. And yes, the blocking with the antiperspirants, the blocking of the sweat glands and the body's inability to release toxins and the increased breast cancer rates, there is a theory behind that. So again, it makes sense when you look at common sense, you understand physiology. Yes, it does make sense. But at the end of the day, until there's formal studies on it, you can't really call it evidence-based per se. So again, great option on a theory that could lean in the wrong direction is possibly just don't use the deodorant. Don't use antiperspirants. Go with natural deodorants. I mean, there's some great brands out there that are fantastic that don't use a lot of the chemicals in them. So, and they make you smell great. You don't smell like, an old dirty sock. You actually smell good. I mean, there's some good products out there that you can use. So it's just one of those deals. If usually there's a theory that leans toward the word cancer, I usually avoid it because it really won't help you to skate on the gray line for that. 888-283-7272. You're listening to On Call Radio. Check us out on the web.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
Connect with On Call Radio and watch On Call TV at InShapeNetwork.com.
Jump in our social media, jump in Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. We'd love to have you hop in and be a part of all that we're doing. Of course, keep you updated on the latest so that you can thrive with your health. That's what we do. And that's what we want to help you do. That's for sure. 888-283-7272. Our lifestyle providers, our healthcare providers in your area that believe the same way we do, all this nutrition and lifestyle-based care we talk about, they can really help you, take you by the hand and get you where you need to be. I would encourage you to check them out. That's for sure. So no matter how dedicated you are to losing weight, you can hit a plateau at any time. There are diet plateaus. Matter of fact, they're easy to hit. If you've never hit one, if you ever try to lose the weight and just get stuck, they're real. That's for sure. And the body gets used to it. So here's the challenge. The body gets in a routine and it really gets used to certain patterns, eating patterns, exercise patterns, and it will come to a screeching halt. But here's some great ways to bust through the diet plateaus, even if you're trying to just drop 10 pounds. You want to clean up your diet ruthlessly. Okay, there's four deadly sins, they say, in diet, but it's fried food, sugar, and cheese, and the fake fats, like the trans fats. So you want to make sure you're not getting any of those, okay? Skip the alcohol. Alcohol adds calories, but it also slows the metabolism, and that's not good. You want to crank that metabolism up as much as possible. You want to go low glycemic on all your carbohydrates. So the refined carbohydrates, get rid of them completely. And you want to eat a meal containing low glycemic carbs about 3 hours before a workout. And it'll actually result in more fat burn than a meal containing refined carbohydrates. Refined carbohydrates are like bread, pasta, cereal, crackers, processed dinners, all that sort of thing. You want to vary your exercise routine. So if you're going to do the same thing every time, you got to change your workout up. Run one day, lift the next day, swim the next day, take a group exercise class the day after. You really need to switch it up. And high intensity interval training, here's another one that I'm a huge fan of. Working out at different levels of intensity is very important. Matter of fact, you'll get more out of 10 minutes than you would out of 40 minutes if you do intervals. And what that means is, for an example, is if you got on a treadmill and you ran, say it's 6 miles an hour, right? You got the little range on the treadmill. So you run for 6.0, let's say, you do a hard jog for 30 seconds. And then you walk at a fast pace like 3.6 or 3.7 for a minute. Then you go back to a 30-minute hard push run and then back to a 1 minute rest and then keep rotating that for about 10 minutes and that's interval training. You'll actually burn more fat doing it that way. It's been proven in science. Strength training is a must. I don't care who you are. I will always start you off walking, but I'm going to lean you toward strength training. It's just so beneficial. Of course, I'm totally addicted to it. I haven't missed a week of working out in 25 years. What does that tell you? So, I mean, I live it. And I love it. And it just makes me feel good, all that sort of thing. So weight training builds muscle, and each pound of muscle burns about 50 calories a day at rest. And according to a survey, about 6,000 adults, about 19% of people who were successful with weight loss included weight training in their workouts. That's pretty strong. So using a heart rate monitor helps as well. Of course, you want to keep your target heart rate between 65 and 85% of your maximum most of the time. You want to just shoot for that. And the way to get your target heart rate is to subtract your age from 220 and you'll get the number. Drink water, half your body weight in ounces of water every single day. So if you're 150 pounds, you want to shoot for about 75 ounces a day, typically. Exercise more than 30 minutes. I like 30 minutes a day. If you go high intensity, you don't need more than 30 minutes. That's about all you need. And you got to get everybody in your life on board. I mean, here's the deal. Your support in life, getting a team around you, building a team around you is vital. Making sure that you have the right tools and the right people on board with you, I cannot tell you how important that is. It is so essential to your overall success. Just make sure to have that. Don't y'all, the haters, they got to go. Haters cannot get on board. We got to get rid of them. Okay, they don't have any place in your life. The haters, the ones that are telling you you're too fat, you can't lose the weight, you're too old, that you're never going to make it, that gives you no hope whatsoever. You want people in your life that bring hope to you in every area and that you can breathe life into as well. All that's important. So critical. If you're out in the pool this year, you want to make sure you cover your eyes. No matter if you're indoor or outdoor, you want to make sure to protect your eyes from the chlorine. And I really would suggest you look for a saltwater pool if possible, But again, if you want to wear some eyewear, protective wear, that's a good idea too. But yeah, a lot of doctors now, ophthalmologists, are saying that, you know, we used to just swim and open our eyes in chlorine. Not so good now. It's important to know why the burning happens. You want to really, the swimmers can develop pink eye and other eye infections, even from contaminated water. So just be careful with that. Better to wear the goggles to open your eyes underwater, and it protects them a whole lot better. You're listening to On Call Radio. If you haven't checked us out yet, go to the website, and all kinds of information there. We've got our website, we've got our newsletter, podcast, we've got radio show, of course, that's on every day, television show that's on every day. If you haven't found our TV show, oh my goodness, check it out. You can watch an episode and then find it in your area. Until then, you can check it out there. But yeah, it is a great way to stay hooked on what we're doing. I mean, a great way. Puts another hour in the charts. I want to thank our producer, Jay Patrick, engineer John Garrison, and the rest of the team. Go tell one person something you learned on the show. Together, we can transform the health of our friends, our families, and our communities. You're listening to the show. It helps you get well, stay well, and live well. Or we're diagnosing hope one person at a time. Remember, you don't have to be stuck where you are. You really can transform your health and your life. It's all about your choices.
You know, you can listen to the Asa Rx audio experience on Spotify and Pandora. For all the ways to watch and listen, check out our show page at asarx.com/experience.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
This episode is over, but check episode notes for links to products and services you've heard about on this episode. Thanks for listening and subscribing. Please share the Asa Rx audio experience with others and stay in touch by giving us your comment or review.